Black holes are some of the most mysterious and powerful objects in the universe. They are places where gravity is so strong that not even light can escape. But what exactly do we know about them? And why is our very own Milky Way galaxy full of hundreds of millions of these cosmic monsters? From massive black holes that hold entire galaxies together to smaller ones formed by dying stars. What exactly are these magnificent beasts? In this video, we'll explore the different types of black holes that exist in our own galaxy and beyond. From the largest, most massive black holes that anchor galaxies, to the smallest, which may have formed right after the Big Bang, we'll look at supermassive black holes at the centers of galaxies. Intermediate mass black holes hiding in clusters of stars and stellar mass black holes created by the deaths of massive stars. We'll even dive into the speculative world of primordial black holes, which could hold the key to unlocking the mysteries of dark matter. And if that wasn't enough, we'll even tackle one of the most fascinating concepts. Could black holes be linked to wormholes and white holes? Could they connect two distant points in space and time? We'll break down what scientists know and don't know about black holes, and their potential to reshape our understanding of the universe. Are black holes as terrifying as they seem? Well, let's dive in. Let's start with the biggest of all. Supermassive black holes. These are the true giants of the universe, with masses millions or even billions of times greater than the Sun. But where do such enormous black holes come from? Almost every large galaxy, including our own Milky Way, has a supermassive black hole at its center. At the heart of our galaxy lies Sagittarius A, a supermassive black hole about 4 million times the mass of the Sun. Even though we can't see it directly, its gravity has a powerful effect on nearby stars and pulls them into orbits at incredible speeds. But while Sagittarius A is impressive, it's actually relatively small compared to other supermassive black holes. For example, the black hole at the center of the galaxy, Wormholes 15A, is an astonishing 40 billion times the mass of the Sun. How do such enormous black holes form? That's still one of the great mysteries. Scientists think they might have started out as smaller black holes that formed in the early universe. Over billions of years, these black holes merged with others and devoured massive amounts of gas and stars and grew into the behemoths we see today. Supermassive black holes play a crucial role in shaping their galaxies. Their gravity not only influences the movement of stars, but they may also control the flow of gas and even regulate star formation in their galaxy. So, could the size of a galaxy's black hole be linked to the size of the galaxy itself? Some scientists think so, and solving this puzzle could unlock even more secrets about how galaxies and black holes grow together. But here's the real question. Are there even larger black holes out there that are waiting to be discovered? As we peer deeper into the universe, we may find black holes that dwarf even the largest ones we've seen so far. Let's move on to a type of black hole that lies between the most massive ones and the smallest ones. These are called intermediate mass black holes. These black holes are believed to have masses ranging from 100 to 100,000 times the mass of the Sun. But why have they been so difficult to find? These black holes seem to fall into a kind of cosmic blind spot. They're too big to form from a single dying star, and too small to have the gravitational influence that makes supermassive black holes easier to detect. So how do they form, and where are they hiding? Some evidence suggests that they might be hiding in globular clusters, dense groups of stars that orbit galaxies. These clusters, which are home to dozens to up to millions of stars packed into a relatively small space, could provide the perfect environment for intermediate black holes to form and grow. But even in these star clusters, their presence is difficult to confirm. If we can find more of these intermediate mass black holes, it could help fill in the gap between the smallest black holes and the largest. Understanding them could also help us figure out how supermassive black holes, those giant behemoths at the centers of galaxies, grow over time. Could these intermediate black holes serve as the building blocks for their supermassive counterparts? That's one of the big questions scientists are eager to answer. While the search for intermediate-mass black holes continues, discovering them could radically change our understanding of how black holes evolve and how galaxies form around them. Next, we have stellar-mass black holes, the most common type of black hole in the Milky Way. These black holes form when a massive star reaches the end of its life. Stars like our Sun burn hydrogen for billions of years, but much larger stars burn through their fuel much faster. Once the hydrogen runs out, the star can no longer support itself against gravity. The core collapses and the outer layers explode in a supernova. What remains is a super-dense core, a black hole. These stellar-mass black holes typically range from about 3 to 20 times the mass of the Sun. But how can we detect something that doesn't emit any light? Many stellar-mass black holes we've discovered are in binary systems, where a black hole orbits a companion star. The black hole pulls gas from the star and creates a glowing disk of gas that spirals inward while releasing X-rays. These X-rays give astronomers a way to spot black holes that would otherwise be invisible. So far, around 50 stellar-mass black holes have been discovered in the Milky Way. But scientists believe there could be hundreds of millions more out there, silently lurking in the galaxy. But how do we find them? Most are solitary, meaning they don't have a companion star to give them away. Instead, scientists look for gravitational lensing, where a black hole's gravity bends the light of stars behind it. As our technology improves, we may uncover even more of these hidden monsters, giving us a clearer picture of just how many of these stellar corpses are scattered throughout the Milky Way. Now let's talk about the smallest, and perhaps the most intriguing type: primordial black holes. These black holes may have formed not from dying stars, but in the very early universe, right after the Big Bang. Could some black holes have existed before stars or galaxies even formed? If primordial black holes exist, they could range in size from 100,000 times less than a paperclip to 100,000 times more massive than the Sun. What's even more fascinating is that these black holes might help solve one of the biggest mysteries in cosmology, dark matter. Dark matter is the invisible substance that makes up most of the universe's mass, and some scientists believe primordial black holes could be the key to understanding through their gravitational effects. But how do we find them? Smaller primordial black holes might have evaporated over time due to Hawking radiation, which is a process where black holes lose mass. This means that many of the smallest primordial black holes might have already disappeared. However, larger primordial black holes could still be out there, hidden in the vastness of space, still waiting to be discovered. Imagine what we could learn if we found one of these ancient black holes. Not only could they tell us about the conditions right after the Big Bang, but they might also unlock the secrets of dark matter and how the universe evolved. Now, let's move on to a more speculative but fascinating idea. Could black holes be connected to wormholes? Wormholes are theoretical tunnels that could link two distant points in space and time. In theory, a black hole could serve as the entry point, while a white hole, a hypothetical object that's at the opposite of a black hole, could be the exit point. A white hole doesn't pull matter in like a black hole does. Instead, it pushes matter out, making it the reverse of a black hole. But while black holes have been observed, white holes are purely theoretical constructs that appear in the equations of Einstein's theory of general relativity. Could wormholes, with black holes as entry points and white holes as exits, really exist? Einstein's theory of general relativity tells us that the center of a black hole contains a singularity, a point where gravity becomes infinite. This singularity should prevent anything from passing through the black hole. So, how could a black hole lead to a white hole if the singularity blocks the way? Some scientists believe the answer might lie in quantum theory. By combining Einstein's theory with quantum mechanics, it's possible that black holes could eventually transform into white holes over incredibly long periods of time. In this scenario, a black hole might slowly stop pulling matter in and start expelling it, essentially becoming a white hole. But this process would take billions of years. So, could wormholes allow us to travel vast distances across the universe, or even connect different universes? While it's still a highly speculative idea, the concept of black holes as wormholes continues to intrigue scientists and fuel debates in both science and science fiction. Finally, let's address the question. Do black holes ever die? While black holes don't die in the traditional sense, they do lose mass over time through a process known as Hawking radiation. This process occurs when virtual particles appear near the event horizon, which is the boundary around a black hole. Normally, these particles would cancel each other out, but occasionally one of them escapes while the other is pulled into the black hole. The escaping particle takes away a tiny bit of energy, and this causes the black hole to lose a small fraction of its mass. But how long does this take? Nah. For most black holes, it would take longer than the current age of the universe for them to evaporate completely. It could take trillions or even quadrillions of years for a supermassive black hole to evaporate. This means that they are essentially eternal on human timescales. So, while black holes do lose mass over time, they aren't going anywhere anytime soon. But imagine the future of our universe. Trillions of years from now, black holes may be the last remaining objects in a universe that has gone dark. Black holes come in many different sizes. From the smallest primordial black holes that may have formed right after the Big Bang, to the supermassive black holes that anchor galaxies. There could be hundreds of millions of black holes in our Milky Way alone, most of them hidden and detectable only by their gravitational effects. We've learned about the potential existence of intermediate mass black holes, which could provide a crucial link between the smaller and larger black holes, as well as primordial black holes, which may help unlock the secrets of dark matter. And while the idea that black holes might be linked to white holes through wormholes remains speculative, it's a concept that continues to intrigue scientists and fuel our imaginations. As we continue to study black holes, we're sure to uncover even more surprises. One thing's for sure, our journey to understand these cosmic giants is only just beginning. Thank you for watching our documentary. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to our channel and click the like button. We're a new channel, so we'd really appreciate your support. Until next time, stay curious.